Hello and welcome to worship here at Dun and Hillside Church on Sunday, the 5th of December 2021. Friends, this is the second Sunday in Advent, and as promised last week, today's service is another Christmas service, but this one is a little bit different. Sometimes known as a blue Christmas service, known here as our Time to Remember service, this is an opportunity to pause, to reflect, to step back from what I call the happy, happy, joy, joy of Christmas, and to sit with some of the emotions around Christmas that we don't often talk about. The hurt, the disappointment, the loneliness, the grief, the loss. There are so many aspects of Christmas that can feel overwhelming. Perhaps financially you find yourselves in a position that is at best uncomfortable and at worst taking over your life. It shouldn't be like that, because Christmas is all about that Christ child, Jesus being born to us, God with us here on earth. Not born into royalty in a palace, not knowing vast wealth, but instead in poverty and humility. Why is it that we feel that we have to go to excess in order to celebrate his birth? It really makes no sense. And why do we think that we can hide from our emotions and that we can hide our emotions from the one who created us, the one who knows us by heart? So each Sunday, when I offer our invitation to come as you are, every week, but this in particular is a Sunday to come as you are, to bring all of the emotions you are experiencing. There is no expectation on you today to be happy or joyful or to celebrate. But if that's what you're feeling, then please do that. It's also a chance to sit with those more uncomfortable feelings of doubt and grief, and loss and disappointment. Perhaps today you'll be thinking about someone you were wishing you were able to spend Christmas with, whether that's because of any restrictions that are or might be in place, or whether that's because at some point over the years they have left this earthly life. Christmas is a time of many different emotions, if only we make space for them. So today we honour them. So please come as you are. Be prepared to have emotions stirred up in you. Perhaps you might want to pause right now and make sure that you have a hanky handy, because this is a time when I don't want to make you cry, but if the tears come, I pray that you will let them and that you will be comfortable with that, safe in the knowledge that you are not alone. So please, come as you are to celebrate Christmas in a different way. Come and worship God. In our call to worship today, I invite you to say with me the words that are prefixed by all. A messenger will be born. Peace is coming. Someone to show the way. Peace is coming. A world is waiting. Peace is coming. Lord, we, your people, wait patiently, hanging on for Advent peace. Lord, we bring you ourselves. We bring you our worship. In our Time to Remember services over the years, we have used the lighting of candles to remember loved ones and to share light in the darkness. We will now light 4 candles to reflect different seasons of grief. We light this candle to remember those people who have been loved and lost. We pause to remember their names, their faces, their voices. We give thanks for the memory that binds them to us this season as we anticipate the coming of Christ. May God's eternal love surround them. We light this second candle to redeem the pain and loss, the loss of relationships, the loss of jobs, and the loss of health. As we gather up the pain of the past, we offer it to you, O God, asking that into our welcoming hearts and open hands, you place the gift of peace. Refresh, restore, renew us, O God, and lead us unto your future. We light this third candle to remember ourselves this Christmas time. We pause and remember the past weeks, months, and for some of us, years of times when we felt down. We remember the poignancy of memories, the grief, the sadness, the hurts, and the pain of reflecting on our own mortality. Let us remember that dawn defeats darkness. This fourth candle is lit to remember our faith and the gift of hope which God offers to us in the Christmas story. We remember that God, who shares our life, promises us a place and time of no more pain and suffering. Let us remember the one who shows the way and who goes with us into our tomorrows. Let us pray. O God of all seasons and senses, grant us the sense of your timing to submit gracefully and rejoice quietly in the turn of the seasons. In this season of short days and long nights, of grey and white and cold, teach us the lessons of endings, children growing, friends leaving, loved ones dying, grieving over, grudges over, blaming over, excuses over. O God, grant us a sense of your timing. In this season of short days and long nights, of grey and white and cold, teach us the lessons of beginnings, that such waitings and endings may be the starting place, a planting of seeds which bring to birth what is ready to be born, something right and just and different, a new song, a deeper relationship, a fuller love, in the fullness of your time. O God, grant us the sense of your timing. Today, as we take time to be with the more difficult emotions around Christmas, we pray that you will be with us ever more closely, Lord. Surround us with your love. Grant us your peace. Bestow on us hope. Be our light in the darkness. And let us now join our voices as we say together the prayer that Jesus taught us, the Lord's Prayer. Please use whichever version is most familiar to you, or you can use the words on the screen. We pray saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Be still, for the presence of the Lord, the Holy One, is here. Come bow before Him now with reverence and fear. In Him no sin is found. We stand on holy ground. Be still, for the presence of the Lord, the Holy. For the power of the Lord is moving in this place. He comes to cleanse and heal, to minister His grace. No work too hard for Him. In faith receive from Him. Be still, for the power of the Lord is moving in this place.
Our first reading today is taken from the Old Testament of the Bible. We turn to the book of Isaiah and read chapter 40, verse 1, and then followed by verses 25 to 31. Listen now for the word of God. Comfort, comfort my people, says your God. To whom will you compare me, or who is my equal, says the Holy One? Lift up your eyes and look to the heavens. Who created all these? He who brings out the starry host one by one and calls forth each one of them by name, Because of his great power and mighty strength, not one of them is missing. Why do you complain, Jacob? Why do you say, Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, my cause is disregarded by my God? Do you not know? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not grow tired or weary, and his understanding no one can fathom. He gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even youths grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. Amen. And now we have two very short readings from the Gospels, which are found in the New Testament of the Bible. First, we turn to the Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 11, and reading verses 28 to 30. Jesus said, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." Amen. And we now turn to the Gospel according to St. John, reading from chapter 1, verses 1 to 5. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. Amen. Friends, in normal times, if you can remember them, we would have a time to remember service at this time of year. Normally, we would offer invitations to those who have lost loved ones over the past few years, to create a space, a safe space for them, to allow themselves to grieve and to be honest about all the emotions they're going through in the time of preparation for Christmas. It feels a little different this year, and not just because we're having this as part of our regular worship diet. No, instead of that, it feels this year more poignant, because the loss that we have experienced is not only the grieving for loved ones, for neighbours, for those in our communities, but also for a grief about normal life. We have been through so many changes over the past few years, and at times it has been overwhelming. But we don't have much of a choice in it. We have just had to pick ourselves up and carry on. And that's good. It is good to have that positivity. But it is also good to stop, to reflect, to think about what we might do differently if we were to have an opportunity again. This year, it's different once more. So far, there are no restrictions around Christmas for us here in Scotland, but we don't know if or when that might change. But what is Christmas really about? It's about God's love for us that was so, so great that he came down to be with us in human form, in a form in which he was limited, so that he could show his love for us. A love that came not into a palace, not onto a throne, not into great wealth or prosperity or even position or status, no. Instead of that, in utter poverty and humility. Christ, through his life, suffered. He felt pain. He felt grief. He experienced every human emotion. I'm sure there are many stories that the Gospels do not tell us about what Jesus himself, as a human being, went through. And so as we gather today, we reflect on all that we are feeling and we offer it to the one who came here to walk alongside us. We were never promised that life would be easy. We were never promised that we wouldn't have any difficulties, there would be no challenges. What we were promised was that God would be with us through everything. So today, in humility, we give thanks, but we also look for the light in the darkness. We look for the hope in the midst of the chaos, in the midst of the depression. We pray for a lifting of our spirits, so that we can come to Christmas with hearts that aren't so heavy. Today we acknowledge everything that we are going through. We acknowledge it to ourselves, and we acknowledge it to the one who knows us best of all. It's almost silly to try and hide from God, to try and hide what we think and feel. He knows. He is with us. He walks alongside us. He knows us. We've been through so much. I know that when I look out on the congregation in church, and when I think about even our online community, I realise that there are many gaps. There are seats that I look to, expecting to see faces smiling back or to hear people worshipping in their own particular ways. And for various reasons, folks are not there. I realise just how much I appreciate each and every one of you, all unique. And I want to take the opportunity today to say thank you to you for being in my life and for bringing the blessings that you do. No matter what we go through, there are blessings. There is always light in the darkness. And we have the opportunity to be the light in the darkness that others experience. So as we share words of hope and peace today on this second Sunday in Advent, we pray that we may know, each one of us, the hope and peace of Christ as well.
Thank you.
Friends, I would like to share with you a poem that I discovered recently, but which was written in 1997. It is rather an emotional poem, so please have your hankies ready if you feel the need. It's good to know a little of the context of poetry, and in this case, when her daughter had a seizure on Christmas Day and went into a coma, Mother Wanda Benke wrote this beautiful poem. It was later shared with friends and family who shared it widely. It may have had one or two alterations along its journey, but they take nothing away from the hope that is found, even in the sadness. It's called I'm Spending Christmas with Jesus. I see the countless Christmas trees around the world below, with tiny lights like heaven's stars reflecting on the snow. The sight is so spectacular. Please wipe away the tear, for I am spending Christmas with Jesus Christ this year. I hear the many Christmas songs that people hold so dear, but the sounds of music can't compare with the Christmas choir up here. I have no words to tell you the joy their voices bring, for it is beyond description to hear the angels sing. I know how much you miss me. I see the pain inside your heart. But I am not so far away. We really aren't apart. So be happy for me, dear ones. You know I hold you dear. And be glad I'm spending Christmas with Jesus Christ this year. I sent you each a special gift from my heavenly home above. I sent you each a memory of my undying love. After all, love is a gift more precious than pure gold. It was always most important in the stories Jesus told. Please love and keep each other, as my Father said to do, for I can't count the blessings and love he has for you. So have a Merry Christmas and wipe away that tear. Remember, I am spending Christmas with Jesus Christ this year. Let's take some time to reflect now as we listen to Carolyn Arendt's beautiful song after this. For the past few years, we have been missing out on so much that before we took for granted. Perhaps after this, perhaps after times of separation, perhaps after times of realizing the difference between need and want, perhaps after this, times will be different. We will grab the opportunities to be with loved ones and to spend quality time. Perhaps after this, our priorities will change. Perhaps after this, the dawn will come. After this.
Thank you. are in our lifetime. Known a shadow like this one. Still, however long this night time, rest assured the dawn will come. And after this, the sun will be shining. And all us in a whole new light, and then may we never waste the sweet gift of a warm embrace. When at last we are face to face, after this, may we never lose these lessons. Till we take our final breath. And when we finally reach the end day, may we know something next. After this, the sun will be shining. All we miss will come to us in a whole new light, and there we will never waste the sweet gift.
Let us come before God in prayer. Let us pray. God, you are not distant from us. You came to us in vulnerability. You offered yourself as a gift of love. We pray today for those who are in the midst of darkness, the darkness of poverty, the darkness of loneliness, the darkness of grief, the darkness of despair. Wherever shadows threaten to overwhelm, wherever they erode dignity or crush the spirit, wherever they hold terror or danger or hopelessness, come, Lord Jesus, light of all people, shine in the darkness. We pray today for all victims and perpetrators of violence, for those whose bodies have been violated, for those whose bodies have been harmed or abused, for those who have lost sight of the holiness of the human body and the value of human life. Come, Lord Jesus, light of all people, shine in the darkness. We pray today for those whose bodies are ravaged by illness, for those who live with chronic pain or fatigue or disability, for those whose bodies draw unwanted attention or discrimination, for those whose bodies are changing through puberty, pregnancy, menopause, surgery or disease, for those whose bodies are failing and nearing the end of life, come, Lord Jesus, light of all people, shine in the darkness. We pray today for our bodies, with all their aches and pains, with all their limitations, the secrets and memories they hold, the lines, scars and markings they bear, their vulnerability, their woundedness. We bring our bodies to you, whatever state they are in. Help us to love, cherish and care for them. Come, Lord Jesus, God made flesh, shine your healing light in our darkness. Amen.
Thank you.
Friends, I hope that this worship has been a time of reflection for you, a time of openness and even a time of healing in God's presence. It is so good for us to be able to be in touch with our emotions. I know it's not a very British thing to do, and we prefer to keep our stiff upper lip. But really, it is healthier if we are able to stay in touch with our emotions and find ways of expressing them. If you find yourself in pastoral need following this service, please do get in contact with me and we will arrange a time to talk or, if possible, to meet. In the midst of all of the excitement and joy and clamour of Advent and Christmas time, I pray that you will also find moments of quiet, of rest, of reflection. I pray that in the midst of all of the busyness, you will find moments to spend in God's presence and be reminded of the reason for the season. It's cheesy, but it's true. And so, friends, it is now time for our blessing. May the blessing of the rain be on you, the soft, sweet rain. May it fall upon your spirit so that all the little flowers may spring up and shed their sweetness on the air. May the blessing of the great rains be on you. May they beat upon your spirit and wash it fair and clean, and leave there many a shining pool where the blue of heaven shines and sometimes a star. And now may the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son and Holy Spirit be with us all, those we love and those whom we struggle to love, both now and evermore. Amen. Friends, next week we continue in our series of Christmas services with a service of lessons and carols. I look forward to having you join with us then, and I do pray that until we meet again, you will stay safe. God bless.